site, get what we need.
And this is this week's Closet Classic.
Everybody, I'm White T. Sock, and this is the White Sock Show from Chicago. Yeah, man, it's great to be here. It's awesome, you know, this is my town, it's a great city. You know, it's just a great place, you know. Behind me is a giant skywriting of Chicago. Actually, it says Chicago. Anyway, yeah, so we're really excited about baseball. You know, we wiped the floor with the Red Sox. Nothing can stop us. Nothing.
Our Halloween episode.
He's your cousin.
Hi, everybody.
Hey.
How's it going?
Yeah.
Welcome to the Halloween special.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
I'm Chris Flaherty. Next to me is the Red Sock, a.k.a. Red Sock.
And hello.
Other next to me is David Murray.
I'm David Murray. Hi, folks.
And welcome to the Halloween special.
Hey, the graphics lined up.
Oh, that's
nice.
Cool.
That's good.
Anyway, so, yeah, this is the Halloween special, right?
Yeah.
I guess I must be invisible.
Well, your camera shot's not on.
Yeah.
There you go.
Ah, I'm blind now. Ah.
Hey, I'm sorry, man.
This is my shot. I'm not supposed to be in it.
Yeah. There you go.
Whoa, shadow.
Shadow. Oh.
Hey, do like a rabbit or something. Do the rabbit thing.
Ha! I'm a bunny.
Yeah, you are.
Hey. With Christopher Robin.
It's Christopher Robin.
Christopher Robin.
I'm trying to do a.
I see.
Oh, yeah. Gee, it's a birdie.
We haven't actually done a live show in a while. I think somebody forgot to play the electric bill.
Maybe.
Yeah.
But it could be worse, couldn't it, Chris?
Yes, that's because it's the Halloween special.
It could be worse, though.
How?
Well, we could be attacked by, like, flesh-eating zombies.
Well, that's
Don't
true.
Get me started on flesh-eating zombies. I mean, they're dead. Just lie in the ground, all right? I mean, no reason to get back up.
Why do they always eat flesh? I mean, why couldn't they be vegetarians when they come back to life?
Well, probably some of them are, and they just, like, walk around going, tomatoes.
Because, well, they're in the ground, right? And so, vegetables...
Cauliflower!
Vegetables are planted in the ground, so basically they're just eating vegetables down there.
Yeah, Chris is right. Actually, when you think about it, the vegetarian zombies don't have to leave the earth. They just eat there.
All I'm saying is every single zombie movie is the same. There's some dude who uncovers, like, the Book of the Dead or something... Accidentally.
Oh, you mean like that one over there?
Well, actually, that was a Simpsons Treehouse of Horror special.
And has to kill them all and at the same time get the girl.
We're having power problems.
There are no original horror movies.
Well, except for the Simpsons Treehouse of Horror special, Bart didn't really have to get the girl.
Oh, no. And, those are parodies.
Yeah, those are parodies.
Yeah, parodies. But every zombie movie is a parody of the one before.
Look, it's either a ripoff. Or a sequel, okay? There is no originality left in Hollywood.
Well,
none.
But luckily here, we can do both. We have a ripoff and a sequel.
This is This is the century of sequel mania, people.
Episode 32.
Yeah, but I mean, summer's over. That's why they're called the summer
saga.
Sequels.
But look at Disney. It's producing thousands and thousands of sequels of its classic movies.
Yeah, and every once in a
while. You know, they're going up in the money, I think, on that.
Of course.
That's
it's Michael Eisner's doing.
But see, every once in a while, they run out of material and they decide to redo one of their old movies. You know, The Parent Trap, all the
more same old movies.
Freaky Friday. Shaggy Dog.
The Longest Yard.
That Longest Yard wasn't Disney.
It was just a...
It's of the same ilk is what we're talking about. Like the Bad News Bears.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm still trying to get over the fact that he and Angelina Jolie were actually dating. It's kind of creepy.
Angelina Jolie and Walt Disney were dating? That is creepy.
No, the guy.
Oh, my word.
No,
Walt
the
Disney
guy.
He'd probably melt.
No, the guy in the Bad News Bears, Billy Bob Thornton.
That's even creepier.
Exactly my point.
Billy Bob Thornton was dating Walt Disney?
No.
See, oh, my word.
See,
that's
this is
funny.
See, folks, this is why this is a Halloween special.
Yes.
It's just plain creepy.
Walt Disney, I don't know.
Everything we do on this show is just plain creepy.
Exactly.
No. Plain creepy. We mean there's other sorts of creepy?
Well yeah, I mean, Bambi 2.
Extravagant
that's
creepy?
Just wrong.
Extra expensive creepy?
Wait, there's a Bambi 2?
Yep.
What is wrong with this world? Okay, you have a sweet, innocent, child classic Bambi, and then you ruin it by making a sequel.
Well, actually...
Remind me again how that works.
Well, actually,
Bambi's got attitude.
No, you're stealing my idea. See, it's actually like a midquel where Bambi has this tries to find a relationship with his father. Now, if you ask me, a Bambi sequel would be called Bambi 2, Bambi's Revenge, where he goes out for vengeance against the hunter for killing his mom.
The show.
That would
be the
best sequel ever.
Okay, but what would Bambi use? A machine gun or a flamethrower?
Can just ram him in the head with his
horns. Hello, he has no horns, man.
He's grown up now.
He probably has antlers when he grows up, when he hits puberty.
Yeah.
That's what happens to deer.
Like that'll ever happen.
This is public access. We can't talk about puberty. I mean, this is a Halloween special, and it's got to be scary, but we can't make it too scary.
Bah!
Semi-scary?
Is that scary?
No.
Oh, man.
Okay, ready on the count of three. Boo!
Bah!
Boo.
You didn't count.
Okay, so I didn't...
We can show them my freakishly long tongue.
That's
okay. No, we couldn't.
FCC
precludes us. I'm sorry.
Hello. We could just, look. If I just show them my freakishly long tongue, don't you think that would be pretty scary?
Yes, but it's
yeah,
not
but you
scary.
See, they're too close to you, so no.
It'd be pretty scary.
If you want to show them your freakishly large tongue, go on what's that show? Ripley's Believe It or Not.
Yeah, do that for
show
us.
Show them right here.
No. Okay.
Why not?
Because
if he does, hit it with the flashlight.
All right. So
I'm taking the flashlight, man.
Fine. I'll just hit you with him.
Ow! Don't.
You'll feel less of the pain because you're being the hitter.
I don't have a tongue.
Room.
Look at that.
Show my freakishly long tongue.
I don't have one. Look.
Well, you're a sock. Deal with it.
Well, yeah, I'm glad I have eyes. Somebody finally got a glue gun in.
Too bad you don't have hands.
I do, but they're at home in a box in case I need them.
Yeah.
Ah ha ha ha. Ah,
did you have to? Seriously.
Hey, that's lovely.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
By the way, our phone number, what's that?
Or Parrish. Graphic person.
I didn't make those graphics.
Yeah, you did. I saw you.
I saw you make them, too.
It's the Halloween show, all right? We got to make it scary.
Yeah, but look, I mean, what if there's someone not at home tonight, right? Okay, they're not at home, and say they're taping the show, but they can't do a call-in. Because look, it's
yeah,
right
like people
here.
T-ball
live
this
tonight,
show.
Listen.
What?
You think they're going to find you, me, and a sock threatening?
Hey, what's the crew
threatening?
Up to?
Hey, you know.
Guys, let's see what the crew's up to. Crew?
Hey, crew, where are you?
What is that, Scooby-Dooby crew?
Whoa!
Scooby's crew, where are you?
There's an explosion in the crew room. Oh.
Hey, one of you camera guys, fix the wide shot. It's got a light in front of it.
It's the eeriness of the show.
Hey.
Stop showing the tongue.
No.
Yes.
Okay, fine.
Welcome to the Red Sox Show. We're here in the basement. We got no power, but we still have a show.
Yeah, so we're doing it with flashlights.
Yes, and you're blinding me again.
Hey,
stop that.
Hey.
What?
You were blocking my face.
I'm having fun. Hey, Rand.
Ouch.
I'm sorry. I thought it was you. I was blind.
My bad.
That was funny. Actually, it was just really funny.
Chris, take off
got
your hat for a second. Hold it in your hand.
Oh, well, look
Chris,
at Whitey.
Take off your hat for a second.
Yeah, no.
No. Just do it.
No.
I'm not within range.
Yes, you are.
No, he's not.
Take your head off.
Further.
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 All right, that's good, that's good. Yeah, he's over there now.
Hello. Hey, come with me over here.
No.
It's the same thing! Darkness! Imprisoning me!
Okay,
oh,
he
I
wants
see.
To tell a spooky story.
Okay,
oh,
I've got
we'll
a
do
story.
That after.
Okay.
Oh,
first off, take off your hat.
No, you're gonna hit me again.
For Pete's sake!
No.
All right, there, okay?
Give me
his
my hat.
Off.
Well, I was gonna say, hit the person next to you.
Give me, ow.
But obviously that's not working the way I planned if you do it, Dave.
Oh.
Can I have my hat back, please?
Yeah, give him his hat back.
I threw it over there.
Where?
Behind you.
Behind me. Hold on a second.
Is this really something you want our parents to see tonight?
What do you mean?
Oh, by the way, the phone number, guys. Give him the phone number and stuff.
All right, there it is. 781. Oh, yeah.
My hat, please.
I'm looking.
781-773-5922. Or Parrish.
Exactly my point. Thank you.
Or Parrish. I like the or Parrish part.
Yes, thank you.
But, I mean, why does it have to be Parrish? I mean, vegetables Parrish.
Is that like a democracy
Would
thing?
You rather have, say, or die?
Yeah,
hey.
That'd be cool.
Yes, but then
this isn't
we...
New Hampshire, you know.
Live free or die? That's what it says on their license
What kind of choice is that?
Well, it's a pretty good choice.
You know, that's...
Yeah,
no,
yeah.
It isn't.
Hey, Red.
It's an easy choice, but it's not a... You know, you should be given, like, two good things. Live free...
Live free or die.
Live free or eat ice cream.
Would you rather have it live free and or die?
That'd no, be cool. Not really.
Hey.
But
so,
I'd like an offer, like, maybe, like, you know... Cash.
You know, Red, I have a question.
Yes.
Okay, it's the Halloween show, so, you know, Halloween's right around the corner. Yeah. So I was wondering if socks go trick-or-treating.
Of course they don't.
Well, no, not really. It's kind of like the same problem we have at Christmas.
Yeah, they get stuffed with candy.
Exactly! It's horrible!
So, are you going with anyone this year?
He's not going trick-or-treating.
I might send my brother Blue out. Oh, I don't mind seeing him stuffed with candy.
Huh. Alright, but what about that cousin of yours, huh?
Oh,
you saw
him?
At the beginning of the show?
He's not going to go all the way to Chicago just to go trick-or-treating.
Really? Hey, what do you guys think? Who's going to win? Is it going to be Houston or is it going to be Chicago?
I don't know, man.
Don't know.
But, yeah, that's right. If you want Red Sox, this is the only place you can go now, at least until next year.
That's
exactly.
True. So only the people in Burlington, right?
But as far as I know, we're still world champions until somebody else wins it, right?
Well, we kind of lost.
I know, but no, they're not. They haven't won a World Series yet, so technically, we're still champions.
So,
yeah, I can do more.
So maybe, maybe there was no curse at all, and maybe we
I'm
were
getting,
just
like,
bad.
I'm getting like subliminal messages from Dave.
Yeah, I'm giving Morse code to Red.
The ostrich moved to Minnesota. Right, got it.
Do an impersonation of that kid from The Shining.
I am the ghost of Access Television.
That's the Sixth Sense.
Okay, give me. Go there, Mrs. Torrance.
That's it.
Okay.
I don't want to go there, Mrs. Torrance.
No, it's too deep. I don't want to go there.
Hi, right, welcome to Red's room.
I don't want to go there, Mrs. Torrance.
Red, you're a ghost!
No, you're a ghost. Who are you going to call?
I was a dyslexic ghost last year. I went around going,
Okay, Red, what am I saying?
I guess you could also say oboe.
Red, what am I saying in Morse code right now?
My flashlight needs batteries.
We can't technically see it.
You're gonna give me a seizure if you keep doing that, so please stop.
Fine.
This is the anti-seizure
okay,
show.
Hey, camera guy. Ready? Ready? Okay.
You can't give the cameraman a seizure.
I'm not. I'm giving him subliminal messages.
He's communicating with somebody that's trying to call in. Thank you for calling the
no
show.
No one's calling in. They're too afraid.
That's true.
Actually,
and to all the ships at sea.
Actually, the phone should be ringing off the hook, because if they're not, then they're gonna perish.
Right.
Oh.
Okay, so...
What a horrible thought! You mean when we leave the studio,
so
everybody within phone range is going to have passed on?
Well,
in case you guys are, you know...
That's horrible!
Actually, everyone...
Chris, that's horrible!
Don't blame me. Blame the Grim Reaper. It's his job. He chose it.
Adam Carolla?
No. Norm MacDonald.
Oh,
so listen,
the other
guys,
guy.
In case any of you are illiterate, that phone number is 781...
That's very mean, you
know. 573-5922. Well, that would be...
Hey, Dave, you appeal to our illiterate audience.
Cool.
He's got special powers.
Thank you.
Six senses.
Whoa.
That was cool.
That was scary.
It's a ghost.
But it's not as bad as being eaten by flesh-devouring zombies.
That's
Do we
true.
Have to continue with the zombies? They're just intolerable.
Well, yeah, they are, actually.
Hey,
you
Red,
need to get,
look,
like,
it's a strobe light.
What is this? Hey, it's the Red Sock Dance Party.
Oh, hey, so one's giant face.
Dave, can you understand what the cameraman is trying to say to us?
Hold on, maybe.
We're being haunted again. Stop that.
He's saying, wrap it up.
Wrap it up? This isn't Christmas.
No. Maybe we have to go to a PA.
Smoke.
We're trying to get her to stop.
Yeah.
We told her that smoking stinks up her hair.
She said she could fix it.
Same with her breath and clothes.
Gross. We told her smoking made her teeth and nails yellow.
She said she could fix it.
But then we read somewhere
this really
about how cigarette smoke gets like into your skin and causes permanent wrinkles.
So we told her.
She freaked.
Totally.
Then she quit.
It was cool.
Really?
Because now we don't have any friends who smoke.
Child, you don't have to be perfect. You just have to be yourself, which, by the way, is pretty good. Do good. Mentor a child. Call 1-877-BE-A-MENTOR.
Hey, kid. My friend wants to know if that girl will go out with him. Pass it down.
Hey, Grandma, ask the girl on the end if she wants to go out with this loner.
The young man wants to know if the girl over there is a donor.
Somebody wants to know if you're an organ and tissue donor.
Yes.
Hey, me too.
Are you a donor? Make sure your family knows your decision so there's no question later.
No decisions are more important than the ones you make about your child's health. That's why you should know about Shriners Hospitals for Children.
Shriners Hospitals provide world-class orthopedic and burn medical care totally free of charge.
And they combine it with progressive research and innovative teaching programs.
There's a Shriners Hospital helping kids from this area. If you know a child that the Shriners could help,
call this number for more information. Shriners, giving help and hope to kids for over 80 years.
In February of... Citizens Police Academy offered by the Burlington Police Department. Join the participants on this series of specials as they take part in a ride-along in a police car, tour a local jail, are shown demonstrations of techniques and equipment, and otherwise see the business end of police work. Watch the BCAT schedule for showtimes or log on to www.bcattv.org.
Yes! Yes. Oh, we got Frankenstein,
this
Igor, and Dr. Frankenstein here.
Well,
and also Kevin Parker.
Oh.
Who is a lot less scarier than those three.
Yeah, well,
which is good.
Scarier than David, too.
I'm sorry.
I
my support staff was having a problem.
Yeah.
I had to go check it out.
We don't have any callers yet.
Well, that's the number's down there.
You know, that number seems wrong.
I'm trying to do another
that
shadow
272-8746?
Hold on. I think I got this.
No, it's 273-5922. Yes, it
yeah,
is.
Yeah, you're right.
Hold on a sec.
They put up the
Maybe
wrong
I can
number.
Get something
we have
here.
Terrible.
Hey, go back to Red Shot.
Wait a minute. Yeah, let's take a look at this. Come on.
Hold on. Hey, can you zoom out a little? Or can you? Never mind.
What
I got
are you
nothing.
Doing?
Yeah, what are you doing?
I was trying to make a bat.
Oh,
okay.
Oh, well, you try
Woo.
Now.
I have a light. I'm shining it at the cameraman.
Hey.
He's having a hernia.
I'm just standing
that's
here.
That's not nice.
Hey, Kevin.
But it is scary, and that's what we're going
for. We're talking
about
movies and stuff like that. Seen any good movies?
Not really.
The only
my sister said she saw the that Wallace and Gromit movie.
Oh, how was that?
That big thing that was attacking them.
Were a rabbit?
She said it was okay, but I don't know.
That's a Halloween-based movie,
yeah,
I guess.
It sounded weird.
It's a parody of the werewolf.
Yeah.
Half man, half rabbit. Wait a minute, that's not very scary, is it?
Actually, no.
Well, then again, if you've seen the Monty Python Holy Grail movie, rabbits are scary.
What about the other Halloween-based movie
that's
out right now,
movie.
Corpse Bride?
Oh, yeah, that's a kid movie.
I haven't seen that one
no,
yet.
No, it's not.
But I like The Nightmare Before Christmas.
It's actually aimed towards...
It's a Tim Burton movie, and Tim Burton movies are just freaky.
Tim
yeah,
Burton
but they're
does
good.
Halloween.
Corpse Bride was good, but it can't compare to The Nightmare Before Christmas.
Yeah, that's true.
But it's not going to... It was good. It was
yeah,
good. That's
it,
all.
Hey,
that's
Jed,
all.
You're not doing anything.
It.
Why don't you go fix that wide shot so it's not having the light in the way?
Yeah, camera. Incapable cameraman.
Yeah. Whoa, there I am. Hey, put the light on me, Kev.
But
Kev, I need some more light.
Turn it back
or
on.
Or they could just switch cameras.
Red, you're the
I feel
ghost.
Like one of those like space entities that talks to people. Hello, people of Earth.
You're Obi-Wan Kenobi in the second... I mean, well, actually, technically, it's the fifth now.
You know what? Just trying to figure out the Star Wars Sager's order really confuses me and makes my head hurt.
Yeah.
I usually have to take a nap afterwards.
Yeah.
Well, episode three, which was actually episode six.
Actually, episode three was
The final
six.
Episode before the next three, which were taped before it.
No, dear. No, hold on.
Yoda, I think he had a seizure.
Yoda, kick butt.
I think what he's trying to say is that...
You should call that number. You should call this number
world,
that's...
Yeah, yeah, call, it,
call
or,
it or...
You know, perish.
Well, I don't know about that, but...
Yeah, I think what
you know,
Red was trying to...
Chris, are you threatening everyone at home?
This
no.
This is a really freaky show, and
yep.
I know
lose
it's
the perish
freaky.
Graphic.
I wouldn't say freaky, I'd say disturbing.
Yeah,
lose
well,
the parish, please.
Why am I on it?
Yeah, let's lose the parish before I get
yeah,
sued.
Yeah,
so you were telling us about Corpse's Bride.
No, Corpse Bride.
Corpse Bride.
I haven't seen that movie.
Yeah, well, basically...
Have you seen any movies in your life?
You saw The Were-Rabbit.
Oh, that's right. No, he said his sister saw
no,
The Were-Rabbit.
No, my sister saw The Were-Rabbit.
Do you usually believe things your sister tells you?
Sometimes.
Okay.
Well,
so what's the last good movie you saw, Kev?
I don't know. When did I see the last good movie?
Hey, look, I can make my eye glint.
This summer
I, like this.
I saw something. Ooh. I don't know. I don't remember the movies that I see, and then I just forget, and then...
Don't you remember movies that
yeah,
you saw?
Yeah, I saw the Star Wars movie, and that was pretty good.
Yeah, yeah, I like
yeah.
the big lightsaber fight at the end
yeah.
there on that planet that was made out of lava.
Yeah,
yeah
and
that was
then
cool.
they all got burned.
I didn't watch it, but I saw the previews.
I was expecting like the Emperor to be like, oh, don't be such a little wimp. Walk it off, man. You're Darth Vader.
Well, he wasn't Darth Vader then.
Yes, he was.
Well, I didn't see it.
Yes, he was.
I didn't see it.
Oh, we
well,
don't want to spoil the ending.
Life.
Wait a minute. We can't spoil the
basically,
ending
the ending's already spoiled.
We don't want to spoil the middle
Star
for you.
What? We don't know what happens
this?
In the middle unless, you know, George Lucas makes an episode 4, 5, and 6.
Life.
Therefore, making the very old ones 7, 8, and 9.
Well, it's not as bad as being eaten by flesh-eating zombies.
Must we keep... Bringing that up, I mean, I get sick of zombies, you know that?
What about
yeah, there's
mummies?
Been a lot of zombie movies out, though.
What about mummies?
Like what?
Oh, mummies? Yeah, you know what? I like The Mummy Return. I didn't think I was going to like it, but I did.
Mm-hmm.
That was a pretty good... What did
I wanted
you think?
To see Serenity, that new movie's out.
Oh, yeah, the one based on the TV show?
Yeah. Hmm. I've never seen that TV show.
Yeah, hey, a bunch of
old.
Rebels fighting against a big evil empire. That's
it
original.
Sounds, it sounds a lot like Battlestar Galactica. Yeah,
oh, they've got a new
that.
One out of that, too, which is, if you're
that
not paying attention.
Movie, which they made into that old show, which
yeah.
got bad because they ran out of money and they kept using the shot, same shot over and over again.
It was like the crash
but
of the week, Battlestar Galactica.
Show.
It used to be like, whose turn is it to crash on the alien planet this time? And then they like landed in like a planet that was like the old west with lasers.
Yeah.
Does that make any sense?
No.
No.
Now
no,
they
it
have
doesn't.
It on the Sci-Fi Channel.
But
we have
then
laser
again,
guns.
This show doesn't make sense.
But we ride around on horses and we get our water from a well. But we have laser guns.
Neither do you.
It's like, hello.
Neither does Red.
Hello.
What? What now?
What?
I don't know. We're getting kind of blurry vision or something.
Blurry vision.
No, we're all ghosts.
Yeah. Oh, I see. Well, is
anybody
that the thing we're
going for?
Anybody
who's watching this knows we all have fun making the show.
No,
except
what I
want to
know
bad.
Is, when you die, do you get the choice of being a ghost or a zombie?
No.
Or is it just a stage?
Well, hold on
human.
A second. Ask yourself this question. If you had that choice, would that mean that no one in the history of mankind has ever chosen zombie? Because I've never seen any.
Weren't
Except
we just talking
that,
about
like,
thousands of zombie movies?
Yeah, but you're talking, are you talking about movies or real life?
No, sort of. But what's the process? Human, zombie, ghost, or when you die, you get to choose... Between zombie
oh,
and ghost.
Oh, in movies, the process is like when
really
you get up
die.
To like the gates of the pearly gates, they
or
hold
maybe.
Out a hat and you reach in, and if you pull out a zombie card, you're a zombie.
Or what if you're reincarnated and if you're good, then you turn into a cow?
You turn into a good zombie, going on, hug, hug!
You turn
but,
into a cow.
But,
I like
but
cows.
Then wait.
A cow?
Wait.
A cow.
Wait.
That's what the Hindus believe. If you're good,
but do you also
life,
get the choice of being a vampire?
Is that what happened to Ben?
No.
Okay.
Do you also get the choice of being a
That's
vampire
a
as
Kevin
well?
Kevin gets it, I get it. And if you read the end graphics of his show, The Something Show, you can
we'll
also
see,
figure that
yeah.
joke out. But for now,
My
we're going to let you hang.
My show is very freaky, and I just make it for fun.
So, I don't
Oh,
get
yeah,
it.
Tell us about your show, Kev.
Yeah, well. Yeah.
This is wild. It's like having a guy
it's,
from another show
it's
on
something.
This show. It's almost like Hollywood.
crossover.
Yeah, it's a show that I just make for fun, and it's really not professional. Well, it's kind of professional, but everyone thinks it's freaky. They're like, wow, you're weird. And I'm like, yeah, but I like to make my show because it's fun. And then...
So that's why, yeah, like, if you want to make a show, if you have an idea for a show, like, hey, look, it's the cloud show, all clouds, all the time. Or, you know, hey, look, it's ice skating, or, you know, the world of spiders. Whatever you want to do, you can come down to BCAT, and we'll teach you how to do cameras and stuff like that, and you can make a show.
Like the Chris Flaherty show.
Yeah.
Yeah, well,
so if you
want to
come down and do a
better.
Chris Flaherty show, you could probably do it better than him. And you could come on and do Wake One.
My show's better.
Yeah, but is your show the Chris Flaherty show?
No, my show is the something show.
Oh, okay, cool.
And it's something.
Yeah, it's always about something.
I don't know. I think I caught an episode that was about nothing.
With that, with that
David.
With
yeah,
that talking eyeball Xavier.
Yeah, he's yeah.
And he's still Chris.
I'm giving the cameraman a seizure.
There is no seizure giving in this studio, young man.
Fine.
Thank you very much. Hey, let's take a look at our camera people. Camera people, can you get a shot of each other?
No,
hey, director, how fast can you react?
No, they're in the dark.
No, they're too dark.
Whoa, there's the crew. Whoa!
Yeah.
Hey, how you doing?
Right, yeah.
And
hey, Kevin, can you illuminate them, please?
Yes, I'm trying, but the stupid flashlight's broken, okay?
And there's Mike Shipka.
Hey, there's, hey, Mike, what's up?
Hey, nothing much.
Having fun in our blackout?
Yep.
Okay, now you
great.
Get Jed.
Isn't it funny that we have no power, but we still have cameras that work?
Yeah, that's what I was just going to say. How do we have a show if we have a blackout?
Oh, it's
just luck,
the camera people are pedaling. It's pedal power.
Yep. Yeah, that's with our slaves.
Slaves!
Nothing.
Hey, word up. It's the Jed Man.
He was on, like, one of the Red Sox shows when I was here, and I was taping it, and
he
wasn't saying anything. He was just standing there going...
He's the silent type.
And no one called
like
on that
show. Like the silent chef.
Hey, kind of like today.
I people like this show.
Yeah, well, he has to be silent. He's the cameraman.
Cameraman.
And now I can't
he
see
gets.
Him.
I'm going to shine this light in your eye.
Maybe I'm going to reflect it right back at you because I can.
I'm the farthest thing from David. Well, maybe not the farthest thing, but pretty far.
Hey, look, I'm the brightest thing on TV. Whoa.
Like I'm public
mark.
Access's top personality.
I'm public.
Hey, my midriff is showing.
Top.
Something show host.
True enough. Hey, when are you gonna do a live show, Kev?
Never.
Why not?
Okay,
well,
so tune in. Never.
Yeah, yay! I have my name back. I'm not maybe David anymore.
And
maybe
he's still
David.
Chris. Maybe David.
I think I'm.
You're
Chris.
Not sure? When you got up this morning, you looked in the mirror. Did you go, "Am I David"?
No.
Good, that's good to know.
Yeah.
Hey, everybody.
Yeah.
You know, when they go to the Y chart, you can actually make out the difference in our height.
Yeah.
Hey, we had an earthquake.
People, why don't you call in? Like
everyone knows.
Okay, we're now
going
to see what the crew
even
thinks of movies.
Even if you make
movies.
Fun of us, you
ready?
Know, just like
Kevin,
make fun of us.
Kevin's
going to
say a movie, and we're going to get thumbs up or thumbs down from the crew in the back. Ready? Say a movie, Kevin.
Star Wars Episode 3.
That was episode 3. That was
they
the sixth one to come
out. Thumbs up and thumbs down from Jed and thumbs up from Mike.
Well, let's see what the crew in the back does. Crew in the back,
crew
thumbs up and
back.
Thumbs down for episode 3. Movie ratings by the crew in the back. Anytime now.
It should
Hello.
Be a spooky themed movie.
Director.
Hello.
They say.
It looks like thumbs up totally.
Thumbs
it looks
up.
Two thumbs up, one thumb
Catherine's
down.
Not putting a
we
thumb up or down.
I think
there's a thumb up.
Yeah,
I think
it was 3-2.
I think they need more flashlights back there.
Well, yeah, they do.
Okay.
They have flashlights back there. They're not just using them.
I think they need to learn
I've
how
got
to.
Another one.
I can't
got another
find
one.
My flashlight. Why? Because it's
got
dark.
Another one.
Well, turn
another
on your
one.
Flashlight. But I.
He's got another one.
Oh, really?
How about The Ring? That was the scariest movie I've ever seen. And I didn't see it, so I don't know.
It's the scariest movie I was ever told about.
It was the scariest movie you ever previewed.
Yeah, the crew is just so cool.
Especially their graphics person.
Yeah, I think that's David, and he is...
Somewhere.
Yeah.
Somewhere. Beyond...
Somewhere over there, yeah. Oh, The Wizard of Oz. The Wizard of Oz.
That's not a scary
Too violent.
Movie.
Thumbs
what?
Down.
Not
thumbs
scary?
Down.
That's not scary in the least.
Thumbs, like, in the trash. Thumbs.
I can't believe you guys. The Wizard of Oz
is
good.
Sucking his thumb.
Okay,
I don't
my
think
turn.
He likes
my turn.
That movie.
Okay, my
I
turn
think he
for
just
a movie.
Sucking his thumb.
The Nightmare Before Christmas.
That was a good
and
one.
And we have down and
we have down for Mike
thumb.
Shipka and Jed's cracking up. No, he's sucking his thumb.
The crew is just. just so cool and you are not, and not really red.
All right, Jed,
you know,
stop sucking your thumb.
The phone number needs to come up, crew people, because people aren't calling in, and obviously they don't know what the phone number is.
They're obviously not scared.
Yeah, well,
something's going on in there.
Who would be
I'm not
scared
sure
by a sock?
Hello?
Hello?
Hey, there's someone.
How's it going?
I hear voices.
Hi.
The name's Ben.
Hey,
say that again.
My name is Ben.
Wow.
My name's Ben. You can call me Vien.
Okay,
we'll call you Vien. And what's your life about, Ben?
Yes, do tell us some of the secret lifestyles of your life there.
You're red.
Yep.
And Kevin's weird.
What do you mean? Hey.
That's great.
What's your favorite Halloween movie?
Favorite Halloween movie?
Yeah.
How to Scare Kevin's Face Off.
Oh, yeah, I love that movie.
That was a great movie.
The one with Kevin Spacey when his face got scared off.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was cool.
I think this person is called Ben Cow, and he likes to be called Ben.
Or Bien.
Or Bien,
that's awesome.
Yeah.
What are you doing for Halloween, Ben?
What?
What are you doing for Halloween?
I'm going to trick-or-treat at your house.
Oh, great.
What are you going to be dressed as?
What are you going to be dressed up as?
He's going as the host of the Something Show.
Yeah, well, he's going to get, like strangled in the night, and he's not...
Actually, I'm going to be Kevin Parker for Halloween.
That's awesome.
That is
the
greatest.
Me too. That'd be cool.
You don't go trick-or-treating.
That is the serious form of flattery. Flattery.
Hey, that was hilarity, flattery.
Flattery.
What? my name, yes, my name sounds like flattery.
Yeah,
Kevin,
cool
stop
name.
Blinding people.
Yeah, well, you
it's
know,
Halloween.
That's what we're gonna do on Halloween. We're gonna go
you
up to people's houses with like a big spotlight. When they open the door, hit it.
Got a question for you, Red.
I've got an answer for you too, Ben.
Yeah, here's my question.
Okay.
What's up with your blackout here?
What?
What's up with your blackout here?
Well, we were just like, you know, we turned on everything to see what would happen, and I guess we found out.
Yeah, but the cameras still work because our slaves are peddling.
Yes, they're peddling.
Lesson learned, electricity has its limits.
Yeah, well, you know what, Chris?
Yeah?
I say that you take the flashlight from Kevin and let Kevin peddle. Now.
Kevin's one of the guests on the show, so he doesn't have to take orders from callers.
True. Let Jed do it.
Besides, hey, Ben.
Yeah.
You didn't give us a Halloween movie other than that Kevin's face-off one.
Okay, the graphics.
The graphics guy is a werewolf. Oh, good to know.
Well, that would explain the hair.
Does anyone have any silver?
And the hippiness.
A Halloween movie. I don't have a favorite Halloween movie.
How about
movie.
The movie Halloween?
You love them all equally?
Yeah.
Nightmare Before Christmas.
Movie. What about that Disney movie,
Nightmare Before Christmas?
Yeah. Focus, focus.
What about...
That's a Tim Burton
I'm trying to think
that's
what's a good horror movie.
Yeah, but
though,
it was
like,
under Disney's name.
Yeah, but...
Sleepy Hollow was good, but could have been better, I think.
Yeah.
How about favorite Halloween cartoon?
Halloween cartoon? What are you talking about?
Yeah, what are you talking about? Are you speaking English?
No, he's
you
not.
You know, like...
I don't think...
Charlie Brown Halloween. Garfield Halloween.
I think Ben...
SpongeBob
needs
Halloween.
To take a walk... To the show.
I am walking.
The audio guy's a vampire.
And the audio guy.
Okay, we need silver and garlic.
I am walking.
That's
well,
good.
At least he's not a flesh-eating zombie.
I'm going to haunt your studio now.
You know, you're like a broken record today with the zombies.
Yeah.
You know, I bet the director is a zombie.
I think I should say
I mean, the audio guy's a vampire. The graphics guy
is a
werewolf. I bet you the phone man is Frankenstein.
No, I'm Bien.
No,
again?
I'm getting
I think we have a tape coming up, by the way.
I can't hear.
The people in the back room.
What are you people saying?
We need to stop because, Ben, you need to hang up and we need.
That's cruel.
The graphics is a witch?
No.
What?
The graphics is a witch?
Hey, Ben.
Yeah.
Stay on the line, because we've got a video, and we're going to do behind the scenes on it and stuff.
Yeah.
Of what?
So.
That wig thing you guys did.
Oh, yes.
That was embarrassing.
So
yeah.
Whenever they roll it.
Oh, you're telling me that was embarrassing?
Yeah.
So I'm not wanted here?
No,
we want you to stay.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry, when we say stay on the line.
Okay, and And we're going to that tape now.
We now present.
It's hot out today. The concert starts. Bill and Jeff said that they'd meet me here, but they haven't shown up yet. I wonder where they are.
Whoa! What the? Oh my God! World domination! World domination! World domination!
Okay. All right. Sorry about that delay. There were some audio problems, but
that
opening shot you saw took quite a while.
Let's talk about this. This is the big fight scene here.
That was me.
That was quite a hilarious scene. Took a while to do.
There's Rita Books from Any News on Ariel. They're getting taken over.
We'll prevail. We shall conquer the world.
I wonder if anyone's really watching our show today.
Yeah, of course. Hey, still there?
Hey, there's me over there.
You can't tell because you got the police helmet on.
I like to include my minions.
And the minions are just talking randomly because they're...
And march into the camp.
And we start attacking!
I like this role with it. It's a small role, but Chrissy pulls it off really good.
Yes, getting pelted with wigs is a difficult role.
It was a stretch, but she pulled it off.
Very nice. You know, I should be credited for this editing. Why is it black and white?
It's live. We want to get
1950s live.
Well, this is 1950s.
It must be a bad thing.
I'm that policeman, and I'm getting attacked by a wig when I shoot the wig.
These wigs are not actually
realizing
alive,
that the local
folks.
Police were overwhelmed by the immensity of the killer wig invasion, Officer Flutterbutter contacts the only person who could save the day. That person being the world's most fabulous genius, Dr. Ima Smart. With Dr. Smart and her overly macho assistant,
okay.
Mr. Burley, the decision
that
was made to make
it?
Their way to Dr. Smart's rocket, Smart
Whatever
One,
I think of the name
and
Mr.
try
Burley,
to stop
I think of
the Xeno hairpieces.
The Xeno hairpieces.
This is not one of my proudest moments, but I have to say I do pull it off well.
Hey, no false modesty there, eh?
I'm not good at acting, but I had to act.
That slow motion walk, I thought we did pretty well.
We could have done that in post, but I like the more natural slow motion walk like that.
And the fact that Dr. Smart comes in and like stops.
Hey, is that Ben Kidd still here?
Ben, are you still here?
Hey, if we lost it, we must have been decaffeinated.
Wait. You do go
now. Every sci-fi movie needs a fight scene, no matter how lame it is, folks.
Yeah, this one is the lamest. But we still have
one. We'd like to thank Mr. Scordis or Miss Scordis for letting us use their name in the background.
No, they actually had me work out for this scene, which was pretty tough.
Yeah, for 6 months he was in the gym like 5 hours a day.
My muscles became titanium. That's why it hurts when I pop.
There's Gio. He had to let his hair grow. And so did Chris.
Actually, everybody in this movie had to let their hair grow.
Except me, because I am special.
And
he wore a helmet.
I get a revolver in this movie. I like revolvers.
Ouch.
Shoot wiggles.
Curly power punch.
Now, Kevin does not actually have a real gun in this movie. It's just
a little bit of a slow reaction there, buddy. But maybe that's because the wigs are blocking their brain synapses, huh?
No, I just knocked the wind out of them with that burly power punch.
Yeah, but did you notice that one of them reacts a little slow? I think it's because the synapses are like...
Wait.
Well,
I just have to say...
There was a deleted scene where we had a Matrix parody during the wig fight scene.
Missed.
Which I thought would have been pretty good.
And she's standing next to a pretty badly grappled.
We're drawing a lot of right here.
That's CG. That's like computer generated.
Yeah, and
that's
for BCAT, that is high tech.
You gotta admit, it does look good.
Go!
In small doses.
Well, you notice that in a lot of horror movies, they just like, you see it actually very rarely, because if they show it all the time,
you're
like,
unless you're talking about Jeepers Creepers 2, I mean, the monster just won't go away in that movie.
I shot that wing, and it fell on the ground, and then it got up.
There was stuntmen involved.
No wigs were actually unarmed in the taping of this movie.
Human beings, that's enough.
Come on, everyone. We're going to break through the stratosphere.
My wardrobe wasn't its best.
Okay,
we're
through.
I think the wardrobe helped, actually.
And then I'm just sitting there at some computer with some wigs.
Now, let me ask this. How is a policeman qualified to control some
weapons?
You would be surprised at what they learned in the police academy.
From who?
I don't know. I'll put it up on screen.
Special cameo by Carrot Top. Actually, it's David.
Oh my God,
yes,
Carrot
David
Top
was a very good wig master.
We should have given him a name.
Of course, this guy didn't say hello, which he was supposed to say hello first.
Actually,
Mr. Burley said...
No, actually, you said
it. How are you, gentlemen?
Yeah, but yeah, I was
not
trying to sound like
gentlemen, excuse me.
Yes, well, he did it fine.
All your base
it would have been fine if you did it in your normal voice.
You have
Can
no
somebody explain that
survive.
Line to me? I know it
what?
Comes
Make
from something.
Your
well,
he says,
David
he
says it's from some badly translated Japanese video game. Yes. I see a lot of things paradoxing these days. I mean, I saw a T-shirt with it in high school. So it must be.
All your ways are belong to us.
He likes that line.
Okay, talk to the hand. Did you do it yet?
I'm going to destroy you. Talk to the hand.
Whoa! There's our big climactic scene.
Now, what sci-fi movie would be complete without a Star Wars parody?
We spent like $5 million on this.
Yeah, $5 million. That's it.
The head part was actually making the rocket airtight so the people weren't killed in the back of the
fire.
That's actually the rocket's original size. We had to cram inside them.
We actually shot them and they blew up. They were like fizzy, wizzy, wizzy.
Yeah, who wants muffin?
No one was actually.
I want a muffin.
Well, really
be good.
Well, the basic idea behind that is, well, Popeye had his spinach and Burley
muffins.
Well,
spinach muffins?
Holy crap.
I don't know, that might be good.
I just missed my hair appointment.
No, it isn't. Nice
Mr. Burley, is this hair appointment?
You put some cheese on the spinach muffin, that'd be great.
Yes, but you don't eat, so how is it going to affect
CD
you?
CD flare.
Yes,
I think
because
we're running out of time, by the way.
That is what you said.
Hey, how much time we got left, guys?
15:57.
15:57.
Yeah, that's 15 minutes.
Well, that's not really very scary,
yeah.
But it is funny.
It is the best we can do.
Well, we were gonna show killer books, but we couldn't find it.
It's around here somewhere. We'll figure it out by next year.
Hey, we did killer books, killer wigs.
I got one complaint.
Book versus wigs.
It's not really Halloween's fault, but what do you guys think about like Christmas shopping starting after Halloween now?
I have no idea.
Why not?
Thanksgiving.
It used to be that Christmas started after Thanksgiving, and now it's like right after Halloween. People are like, oh, it's time to go Christmas shopping.
Thanksgiving and Christmas should be collaborated into one holiday.
Yeah, Thanksmas? No. Then we would get less days off from school. That would be terrible.
You would combine it into
No, we'd get a bigger vacation.
No, we wouldn't. We just... Yeah, but it's better when it's...
Wait a minute.
More
what,
and small
if you combine the two of them, what would that entail? Would you have turkey under your trees, or would all your gifts be stuffed in the turkey?
That would be disgusting, and I don't think I want to combine that holiday, so I should smack Chris.
I could see. Yes, it would be horrible.
All right, how about this? How about this? How about this? Thanksgiving and Halloween together.
Well,
a nice
maybe.
Thanksgiving dinner,
all the candy
then you go
would
out for candy.
Inside the turkey.
Well, you see, if you
you're
combined,
not making sense here.
If you combined Thanksgiving and Christmas, then you'd have like two feasts. Because
no.
At Christmas, you have food.
No, but
you have a lot of food.
If Thanksgiving and Halloween were together, you'd have the big Thanksgiving dinner.
Thanksgiving and Halloween together. Here, kids, take this turkey, go around, fill it with candy, and we'll cook it.
Can I talk?
That's disgusting.
Can I talk? Okay. Have the Thanksgiving dinner, then go out for trick or treating.
I've got chocolate all over my turkey.
You're not listening to me. You never listen to me.
There must be other holidays that would be better to combine.
Fine. Easter and Thanksgiving.
Easter and Thanksgiving. Okay, that might work, I think.
Okay, have the Thanksgiving dinner, then
Hide the eggs.
To make the egg salad with the dinner, you gotta go find the eggs.
I don't like egg salad.
Well, neither do I, but...
Hey, why don't we just, like, skip the middleman and hide the turkeys?
Well, that's because holidays need to be given. I'm shining a light on you.
I feel like I'm being questioned. I don't know. I don't know that answer.
Where were you on the night of July 19th?
I think I was camping.
You know what? I think I was camping.
I think I was in California.
Well, the light does
That's
work.
Cool.
It's the blinding light of truth. And it hurts. Ow.
The truth hurts.
It is like a laser. I am Darth Vader. Yeah.
I wonder, do they have like lightsaber razors for shaving?
That would hurt, actually.
You know, in Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, they had like a lightsaber knife, so it toasted the red as you cut it. Did you see that movie?
No.
No, but I want one of those. That'd be great.
Yeah.
I wanted to see it, but people told me it wasn't that good, so.
Well, you gotta read the books. You can't really appreciate the movie unless you see the books. Well, maybe you like the movie better if you don't see the
books.
That's
like Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, yes,
the but the books in Lord of the Rings are really confusing and long and like detailed. They're like, so Frodo ate a walnut.
But these
and
days...
And then they looked at a tree, and then they started mocking
me. My favorite
like
missing scene from Lord of the Rings is, like, you know when Frodo and Samwise leave the Shire?
Mm-hmm.
And Samwise goes, this is the farthest I've ever been from the Shire.
I've seen that part.
I was waiting for him to take one more step and go, this is the farthest I've ever been from the Shire. Take another step. This
now it's the farthest.
It's like, Samwise, shut up! Get going! Stop doing that.
Actually, I did see the Fellowship
but,
of the
you know,
Ring.
The movie was long enough.
Didn't really appeal to me.
Yeah, well, they were like, stop.
See, these days, people, like, they don't really mind if they read the book or not. They just go right and see the movie.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, that's true. Hey, why don't they do movies based on, like, those cliff notes?
What's that?
You know,
what are cliff
notes? Like, if you're going to study for a test, you get cliff notes because it tells you all the things you need to know. You don't have to read the book, really. Oh, I'm sorry. Did I say that? You should read the book. It's good. But
yeah,
if you need to know all the stuff you need to know, you grab a cliff note thing or whatever the other one is called. I can't remember.
Or, you know, the writers could just be creative and make up their own stories.
I don't know if that worked for school. Did you read Lord of the Rings for your book report? Yes, and I decided to make up my own story. Frodo and Samwise jumped on motorcycles. And they got a job at a delicatessen. And one day they encountered Kermit the Frog, and there was a big gun battle.
Well, if you could rewrite a story just knowing what the title was, what would you do? Like, say I gave you the name Lord of the Rings. What would you imagine the story to be about?
There's this rich guy who has a ring
with Rocky
and then
and
he
Apollo
takes
Creed.
The ring.
Hey,
like,
I'm Kevin.
He's like, I have a Super Bowl ring, and then he's like all happy and he's rich and
wait a minute.
That's the
whoa.
My head! Where'd it go?
Are you okay?
Oh,
feeling
okay.
A bit lightheaded?
Yeah, actually.
I am the headless man.
No, you're me. Hey, look, it's the Red Sox Halloween.
The doc gave you Red's head. Redhead.
Yes, you can be Red Sox for Halloween.
Well, yeah, I
I'm Glinda the Good Witch.
The Wicked Witch of the West. The
you know what they always
the
say,
East,
two heads are better than
the
one.
The semi-irritated Witch of the South.
You never see the Good Witch of the South. You never see the Good Witch of the North.
Well,
she comes to the Munchkins. The Munchkins
are
messed up.
Well, there are two bad witches, so yeah, I guess they would be two good
witches.
Well,
let's think.
Yeah, South, North, East, West.
If she lived on the beach, you know what she'd be?
Well, was the East killed or the West killed? I mean, they both...
Our cameramen are making weird...
But both were killed, but which one was squashed by the house?
The one from the east.
Okay.
And then the west was trying to get Ruby Slippers so she could kill Dorothy.
Did you hear about the one that lived on the beach? She was always hungry. You know why?
But which one? What was the good witch of the south doing? What was the good witch of the south doing?
She was just sitting in her little castle. She's like, oh, I like to do it.
She's just like, oh, Glinda can handle this. Time to go on my vacation.
Yeah, she must have been on vacation at that time. She came back and went, what? The East and the West Witch are dead?
Oh my God.
A girl from Kansas dropped a house? Why did you call me?
You never call me anymore. Why don't you tell me these things?
Oh my gosh.
Hello. It looks like a big lightsaber.
You know, I saw that movie and like you ever notice how Toto is sitting on that big like plow thing?
Hey.
And he's looking around like he's like freaked out. He's like, ah, get me out of this thing.
Well, he was like the very, he was like
pointy. What if he fell and like,
he's the very first animal actor, I guess.
No, they had like
what
silent
if he
movies.
Fell off? He'd be like, whoa!
Well,
wait a minute. When they had silent movies and they had like the dog warning people, did they put up a lower third that said woof woof woof?
I imagine.
What is it, Lassie? Weed. Woof woof woof.
Well, actually, I think they had sound with Lassie.
Well, that you know, I think it was like Rin Tin Tin or something like that.
Never heard of him.
That's a stupid name.
Sound of water rushing, and then like the people going down the river, the dog runs out. Sound of dog. Woof woof woof.
Yeah, well, this show is getting kind of boring because no one's calling.
We've got 8 minutes, 27 seconds.
And the graphic people and the director are making some kind of lava lamp in the middle of you guys.
Apparently they're transforming into zombies, I bet.
Oh, but nothing would be worse than flesh-eating zombies.
Yes, nothing would be worse than flesh-eating zombies.
Hit the flashlight on the... Huh? Okay, I'm not paying attention to our cameramen. They're freaky. Let's see our crew. They must be having some fun. Let's see
that
side cam.
Let's see
that crew cam.
Crew cam.
Crew cam.
Yes.
Hello, turn it on.
Hey, put me on crew cam.
Slaves!
They are not our slaves. They are our servants.
I want to see what it's like in the back room. Just switch Chris.
You know what? You are very shy people if you're not turning on the stupid crew cam. Who cares if they know you're...
They've seen you before.
Making a show that's terrible. I mean,
whoa, two Chris's.
Sorry. Now I'm double-headed. Now I'm not because I moved my head.
That was a movie that I haven't seen. The one with the guy with the two heads.
Yeah.
Was there such a
movie? How is that like
hey,
a
Hey, there's our crew.
Yeah, there we go.
They're cool. What? Yeah, you're cool, crew. Okay, our crew's messed up.
They're in the shadows, but I can tell which one's Dave.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He has the big hair.
Now.
I mean, first you call him a hippie, and Ben called him a werewolf.
Amish.
Okay, that sounds like a really bad movie from the 70s. Hippie werewolf. It's a full moon, and
it's
he's
a werewolf.
Blue.
What
is
if,
going?
I mean, there's obviously more were creatures out there. I mean, there's were rabbit, werewolf. What kind of creature would you like to be?
A were sloth. It's a full moon. Yes, even in the dark of night, a man who is good and says his prayers can still turn into a were-sloth.
How about a were?
A were?
A were-duck.
What about a were-sock?
A were-dog.
A were-sock?
A were-sock? Wait a minute, what if you were bitten by, like, a were-man? A man who turns into a man.
A were-snail.
Is that hello?
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 It's Bien.
Hey,
Ben's back.
That's good.
Good, because we have no other callers. Because everyone who watches this show probably is like,
we're
oh my god,
call,
I have to change
we're
the channel. These people are
freaking.
I might catch the freaking.
We're going to call him Chuck. Down. We have a different caller. His name is Chuck. Hi, Chuck.
Did you see Killer Wigs, Chuck?
Si,
wasn't it the greatest movie ever, Chuck?
Si, senor.
And don't you think that Ben Cao was a really great actor?
Si, senor.
That's good.
Ben Cao was in that movie?
No, but I just asked him if he was a great actor. Because I know that nepotism is a great thing.
Well, on my show, he's a pretty good actor.
Mm. That's true.
I've seen him on your show.
Chuck. Yo, Chuck.
Who's Chuck?
Wait, I'm going to throw this ball to you guys. Ready? Catch this ball. That wasn't a very good throw.
Hello? I'm going to move it get it? They're gonna, he's
ready?
Gonna
here we go.
I'm going to
hit it with like a bat.
Poof.
No wonder you were kicked off that baseball team.
Yeah, you got skills. Hey,
you guys have to catch this. I feel like I'm playing croquet and getting brain damage. Most people have, like, mallets. Oh.
Red, throw it at Kevin's head.
You know what, Ben? I'm going to throw it at your head.
Now.
But you can't.
He's going to jump through the camera, out your TV set, into your house.
There's some scary guy standing next to me.
Scary guy?
There's well, at least it's not a flesh-eating zombie.
I know, really.
It is. It looks like one.
I think his name is...
He said train. Something about
train. Oh my god, it is a flesh-eating zombie.
I'll poke it with my flashlight.
Trains?
Go away.
It's a flesh-eating zombie.
Why is he saying trains?
Ew.
Flip. It's a flesh-eating zombie.
Okay, go away
no,
now.
No, I think his name is...
Go away.
Okay, we have to go. That's our show. We gotta run. Bye-bye.
Hit the music. Left.
Happy Halloween, everybody.
We have four
if we survive,
left.
See you Thanksgiving.
I'm Chuck. I'm Bien. Whatever.
Vegan?
Have a good day.
Thank you for calling.
Wait. Guys.
We have 4 minutes to
So apparently we can just hang around with the zombie.
Hang around with the zombie? Hey, zombie, what's your favorite movie?
It's not nice.
Never seen it. Who's in it?
No, I think he means it's not nice that we've been making fun of zombies all night.
This is not like a Geico commercial.
That's okay,
because
it's not even a zombie.
It's so easy a zombie could do it. Oh, sorry, I didn't realize you were there.
He's been in the background the whole time. I mean, that's why the cameramen are sleeping.
Oh, he ate their brains. That would explain some of the shots tonight.
Yeah. Well,
hey,
thank goodness this isn't a flesh-eating zombie.
Who's our mystery guest? Somebody with eyewitness protection.
You can't follow me.
I mean, you're probably not a flesh-eating zombie, but flesh-eating zombies are disgusting. They are.
He's one of the vegetarian zombies we talked about earlier?
I don't know. Are you a flesh-eating or a vegetarian zombie?
My mother's a flesh-eating zombie.
Okay, so apparently we insulted the zombie's mother. We're in trouble.
Yes, we apologize to all the flesh-eating zombies that...
No hard feelings, right, flesh-eater?
I thought he was a vegan.
Eat Kevin first. He's a cannibal from the afterlife.
Okay, I'm
quick,
out of here.
Quick, I'm going to beat him with you. Ow!
Oh, jeez. I think the red sock bit you.
Well, at least the zombie isn't trying to bite me.
Bye, zombie. Yeah.
Oh, God.
Thank you for
get away.
To
get away. Back off. Get red.
I don't have any
flashlights.
Get red.
I don't have any flesh. Unless you're a wool-eating zombie, I don't think I'm going to do you any good.
What do you have inside of you?
Get Kevin.
American goodness.
Okay, we have to fend this zombie off for 2 more minutes, and then we got to run like heck.
Yeah, that's a flashlight. Do you like the flashlight? Ooh,
don't go into the light.
It cannot roast us, all right? I mean, I know you
I
zombies like us medium well.
Why is he
so what's your deal
us?
Eating us? Get away! Get him! Get him!
I think that's all the time we have. It's time.
Yeah,
to,
it's time to go.
Yeah, we're just leaving.
Roll
even
that
if
music.
We have
roll that
end credits,
please.
Bye, everyone. Happy Halloween.
This
if we survive, see you Thanksgiving.
It's black.
It's very dark.
Ah, that hurt.
Okay. All right,
we're
guys.
Still on air.
Guys.
Look at us.
Guys.
Look at
us. The zombie's still here.
Well, he's leaving. Yeah, I did the graphics. I also did some other things.
Kevin, he's eating your leg.
My leg's right here. Ah! That's not cool.
Oh, my God. Let's get the heck out of here.
Zoot, zoot, great mind. That's cool.
Oh, God. Here he comes.
Okay, you're shaking the table. That's not cool.
Get me out of here.
The White Sox show.
Red,
protect. This isn't the White Sox show. This isn't the White Sox show. This is
He's
the Red Sox show.
Imagine what it feels like to be a hero every day. You can make a difference in the Coast Guard.
Jobs that matter.
Search and rescue, saving lives. Your answer in the call. It's a job that matters, where you can do it all.
Join the United States Coast Guard or the Coast Guard Reserve. Stop drugs. Save lives. Protect the environment. Be a hero every day.
Imagine what it feels like. You can do it all.
Call toll-free 1-877-NOW-USCG. The Coast Guard. Jobs that matter.
Coast Guard.